Let us discuss one more concept related to vertical circular motion, that is vertical circular motion outside a circular track. See, we are having a fixed sphere and at the top of this sphere, we have kept a body of mass m and we throw this body with an initial horizontal speed, with an initial horizontal speed u. Now, it depends on u that it will start following the outer surface of this fixed sphere and at some position, say at an angle theta, it may be possible that the normal reaction acting on the sphere becomes zero and it'll leave the circular track and start following the projectile motion. It is obvious that as mg is acting in downward direction, as the body moves along the spherical track or the circular track, its speed will increase. So, at any point, say if it starts from A and it is at an angle theta, when we call its position as B, then the speed of this body at position B can be given by using work energy equation from position A to position B. Say we use work energy equation from A to B. In this situation, we can say that at initial position, it is half mu square, the kinetic energy of body. As it has fallen by distance h, this distance h can be given as the total r minus r cos theta. So, we can write it plus mg h, h is r into 1 minus cos theta is equals to the final kinetic energy, that is half mv square. Here m gets cancelled out. And on solving, we'll get the speed of body as a function of angle theta as root of u square plus 2gr 1 minus cos theta. Say if this equation is our equation 1, we can use this equation to find out the speed at any position when it is following the circular track. Now, at this point B, we can also write at point B, body will be experiencing mg in downward direction. So, if this angle is theta, in radially inward direction, it will be experiencing a component of its weight, that is mg cos theta. If n it is experiencing in outward direction, we can write at this position, mg cos theta minus n is the necessary centripetal force, which is mv square by r. Here the value of n we can write it as mg cos theta minus mv square by r. If we substitute the value of speed v over here, we will get the value of n as mg cos theta minus m by r. We just substitute the value of v square, that is u square plus 2gr 1 minus cos theta. On solving, we get n is equals to 3mg cos theta minus 2mg minus mu square by r. So, this relation you should keep on your tips because this equation number 2 is also very much beneficial when we handle various kind of problems. And the position where n is going to be 0, that angle, a particular angle where n becomes 0 and particle follows the projectile motion can be given by equating this n to 0, we'll get the value of theta. Let's continue with that. Let at some point theta is equals to beta on track, n becomes 0. And body will leave the circular track. Then, from equation 2, we can directly write 0 is equals to 3mg cos beta minus 2mg minus mu square by r. So, in this situation, we will get the value of cos beta as 2gr plus u square by 3gr. Or beta we can write cos inverse of 2gr plus u square by 3gr. And the point where it will leave the circular track, the equation 1 gives us the speed with which it will start the projectile motion. So, these all results are quite helpful for handling of various problems. So, be careful about all these cases.